Hey guys, what's going on? It's Mod Simon here, joined tonight with Mod James and Medium Clue Caskets. Tonight is the night. You and Mod Wolf, last week with Easies.
I did 10,000 Easy Clues.
10,000.
I can't remember, it was average clue, it was 54k per clue, I think it was.
Not bad at all. Yeah. So what, that must be for 10,000, over 500 mil. Really nice.
I can't even remember now. It was like a good chunk of money. I think it was that.
We're on the live service, don't you worry. We're joined here by Mitsign. We're over in World 5. You can join us at... We tried to go a bit remote, avoid some of the lag. We're on Mosler Harmless, so you can come and join us there. And we're here at the bank, ready. Are you set up?
I'm opening.
You're opening clues. He's gone. He's gone for it. I will be able to pop over to James's screen. So here you go.
What a
one to port across. And how many is that in? 13. Some say it's unlucky. Not for you.
Wow.
6.9 mil. That's going to take some beating. I'm not even sure the briefcase, one of those new items, is even that much. At least the offhand one isn't. So, damn. That's pretty nice, guys. Right in there with some great loots. That's pretty good going. Okay, so I'm going to jump back to my screen. That was pretty nice. I'm going to go...
Someone said rip the ears. Was that too loud?
Probably. It probably was. I did overreact a little bit. So, luckily, Mod Easty, the legend himself, has plugged it in so we can view rewards and just constantly spam through them. So let's get started. That's one medium clue. Only 4,999 to go. Let's get on with it. First one, though. Not bad.
I'm clicking through. I think I just got a cat mask.
Okay, 13K. Wow, that's tragic. Cat mask is about 3 mil. All right, 10K. Nothing good. Prismatic. Nothing good. Ooh, 300K. Purple LED shirt. Hopefully we'll get a few of those.
Someone said Mike's getting blown out. So I'm going to try putting that down. Put it down on there. Just put it down a bit on there. Should be...
Okay.
We use this set for the one, like the Q&A stream we did earlier, and it was absolutely fine. Yeah. So I don't know why.
Now we'll...
Do you want me to go just listen to it?
I can definitely hear some kind of echo. I don't know where that's coming from, though. And that's turned it on. So I don't know. We'll try and figure it out. Just let us know how it's going, guys, and we'll sort it out.
Have you got anything else open?
I've got the music going. If that's too loud, do let me know. But either way, let's get on with clues and we'll figure it out. I'll leave Mod James to do with that one. So 35.
I want to go check it out if you don't mind.
Yeah.
It sounds good now. So another cat mask. That's absolute crap.
Wow.
To be honest.
No, cat masks are rare because
that's rare.
So I've got. All right. So I'm gonna bring out a few stats for you guys. And one thing you will be hearing about the masks is that. Individually, they're all actually quite rare. Together, they all have the same rarity as anything else, like Ranger boots, like your Adamant G helm and stuff like that. But on their own, because effectively, oh, there you go, a bat mask, nice. So the bat mask itself, on its own, oh, combined with a Zara cape, that's pretty good, Zara cloak. 2.3.
It's got another pair of Ranger boots, by the way.
What the? Wow, he's going for it. He is really, really going for it. I need to start cracking up. I've even put in a preset. So I can go through these pretty quick. Obviously, I'm going to have to speed up because it's just over 1 a second, didn't we work out, to get it done in an hour, which I don't think is going to happen. Guthix Cloak, nice to build that up, start getting a bit of a set. And periodically, we'll organise the bank. Right, I'm going to start speeding up, guys. We've got to get through these. Ancient Page, nice to see. 22K, nothing too valuable yet. Can't believe you've already got Ranger Boots. That's probably going to be one of the most valuable loots we're going to see.
Two of them,
there you go.
I just want to see the average...
Red headband there, Zami Page.
So the lowest loot... The lowest valued loot from an easy clue.
I just got 9.9K, so that's pretty low. You're not going to get much lower than that.
The lowest from an easy was 160.
Oh, 9.7K.
I think it was 163 coins was the lowest from an easy clue.
There you go.
I just got a 3K, so like 3.1K.
Oh, wow, 3?
Yeah, so like that's pretty low.
I did some of this in testing, just making sure it was working. And I mean, I just got 6K there. I did not get much lower than 5. And to get lower than 10 was rare.
But I'd love to see that.
I think there's some purple early legs there, so I'm pretty much got set.
Do you know how rare the Ranger boots are?
All right, okay. So I am no coder. I have read the RuneScript file to try and figure out the drop rates. So don't quote me on this, which is a nice way. To be fair, it's good not to be able to be quoted on it, because I don't want to give out the exact rates. It'd be a bit of a shame. I believe it's in the ballpark of 1 in 250.
What Simon believes.
It's pretty rare. It's not like stupidly rare, but then again, medium clues aren't the easiest thing to come by. I'm pretty sure I just got a pith helm.
Medium clues were a weird one, right? Because you do Slayer, and as soon as you're a reasonable level, you get hard clues. Yeah. Like jellies drop hard clues, I think. Pretty much everything exactly. Above you that just, drops
ooh,
hard
nice
clues.
Nice green boater.
Easy clues, you go pickpocket ham. Oh, look at that, Simon.
What have you got?
Another pair of Ranger boots.
Oh, hold on, let's port across.
That's doing quite a lot, though, to be fair.
6.9, wow. How many are you on? 560. Dude, I'm on 100. I need to speed this up.
No, like I was saying, I'll spam and then I'll go slower while you spam.
Oh, I just got an elegant white blouse and an Addy Helm G in one over a mil. Pretty nice.
I just got a pith helm.
I didn't, didn't hover over it. Obviously, we're going to spam through quite a few of these, but combos. Now, ooh, just skip past it. God damn. Here we go. Offhand briefcase. Briefcase.
Is it what?
I was trying to say suitcase, then I realised, shit, it's not a suitcase. And I just said a swear. That's a good start, guys. You'll probably hear a few of those tonight. Right, here we go. So,
how much is a briefcase worth?
6.7 mil, I believe.
Okay, so I just got wizard boots.
It's 6.9 in the...
All right, I swear down, hand, so. Wizard boots used to be off easy clues. I was convinced that wizard boots were an easy clue.
Actually, maybe. I don't know. I know it was always the Amulet of Magic Tea, although the Amulet of Magic Tea was never in the original batch of clues, from what I was aware.
So if you go back like really far, I'm convinced Wizard Boots used to be off an easy clue. I might be wrong. There's a good chance I'm wrong. But I was convinced that was the case.
Just got another purple Ellie legs. We'll take a look at the bank in a second, guys. Obviously, I just load it up and use my presets. You don't really get to see it. But when I get to maybe like the 250 mark, we'll have a look at the bank in a second.
There's a guy at the bank spamming old RS3 is better than our old school RS. Guys, just get along. It's much easier. It's much happier as well.
We're not going to be doing any re-rolls tonight, guys. Obviously, we're just trying to see 10,000 loops. There's no point in seeing 13,333 if we like rolled every three goes. It just doesn't really make any sense. We're opening 10,000 caskets. We just want to show you 10,000 loops. Because that's a pretty good sample size. I don't even know anyone that's done 1,000 since the counters have been put in. I mean, I'm sure there are people. And
easy clues, yeah. People have smashed out so many of them. I imagine there's people have done. I'd love to see. Is there a high scores? I don't even know. I should know.
I know there was a seasonal high scores for clues.
Yeah.
And that's what drove, like, oh, Addy, plate body, G, not bad. I look forward to completing the set of these. Now, I did a few of these in testing, and one thing I never got was a Willow combo. I got the magic and the U.
I just got
only two items for that. Now, this is an interesting one. So again, another two-item clue. But what happens with this is, for easies, it's you're guaranteed to get two items, right?
Yeah, two slots of
and
items.
Then you get,
but you can get one.
You can get one in a single slot. So this is what's happened here. So with mediums, you will always get three. But I have got three, and I've got three helms. That's tragically, let's face it. That's pretty tragic. But I've got three helms, and two of the rolls that I got were both Addy Helms. They've stacked. But you can get up to five. So in mediums, it's between three and five with, I believe, it is just a direct average of four. Ooh, there we go. We're starting to build up these Addy G pieces. Not bad. A boater there, another one.
How many are you at now? Whole clue.
Only 224. I'm going to get up to past 250. And then I'm going to, so this is the last invent, and then I'll open up the bank. It's pretty good to get a briefcase. I didn't catch it, obviously. Another pith helm. Oh, another wall back-to-back pith helms. Are they called pith helms?
I'm pretty sure it's got a pith helm.
All right, let's have a look.
All I know, right, is...
Oh, two boaters in one there. Oh, and a ranger boots that he's just skipped, guys. Guys, I'm not good at holding on these things. But there we go. So I've finally pulled out my first rangers. That's pretty nice. Okay.
All I remember is Mod Matt K gave it a very different name.
What did he call it?
I'm pretty sure he called it a nipple hat.
Okay, yeah, I'm not sure we're going there. I've already got a Zabby Page set. Not bad, guys, not bad. Let's clump these together. I'm not going to do too much bank reorganization. We'll do that at periodic times throughout the evening. But you can see there, over 250. That's not a lot, but that's quite a lot of clues in someone's lifetime to do. For obviously someone
are you at 250 now?
Yeah, so I've got an offhand briefcase and a ranger boots. Not bad at all. Cannot complain in the slightest. So... shall I port across to you? How are you doing?
Yeah, I've got 1,344 done.
Oof,
but I'm going to slow it down now so you can see a loop. I've been going...
Okay, I'm going to fade across to James. You're going to need to see how he's getting on.
So I'll talk you through it.
Do you want to do a bit of rearranging of the bank, I guess?
I'll do that towards the end. I don't think there's any point doing it now. Right. So I've done 1,344 and I've got six ranger boots. So I'm slightly ahead of your 1 in 250 and drop rate at the moment. They're only just slightly ahead, but it's kind of holding true. What I will do is I'll rearrange the bank at the end. Exactly 2 mil cash somehow.
Nice. Well, it's because it drops like, you do get 10Ks, 30Ks. I just got a Zami cloak there, pretty valuable still.
So the reason I've done so many is, the reason I've done so many is that in order to get 10,000 done, that's a lot of clues, right? Oh, I wanted to know what bow that was. got double bow. In order to get 10,000 done, that's a hell of a lot of clues. And if we're just to open them so you can see them all at this speed, it'll take a long time. So the way we do it is Simon will open some, and so you can see them, while I kind of spam through them. And
it's
then
got another Ranger boots.
We'll switch places so you can see all the loot's being
that's
opened.
Good.
And then you can see the full 10,000 at the end. Mate, adamant
crossbow. Oh, another Ranger boots. Wow.
How many
I just skipped past it. I'm on three now.
You're on three total. Oh, there's wizard
boots. Three, but in 448, that is not bad. I'm already on two wizard boots as well. So, yeah, you're going to have to catch up. So, yeah, going back on some of the stats, obviously that's what you guys are really interested in. Now, with medium clues, the individual pieces, I believe, are a little bit rarer.
What do you mean individual pieces?
So compared to, say, easy clues, because obviously you only get between two and four on easy, and you get between three and five. So actually, the chance of getting an item on a medium is a bit more common, a specific item, about 1 in 250. I say that, it's not actually that, but I don't want to give out exact numbers because I've probably got it wrong.
If it's a rough 1 in 250, and then there's a lot of items, obviously, like this.
So we're expecting to get about 40 Ranger boots. The one thing, though, that you obviously we need to say is not everything has the same drop rate. So there are some times when you roll, for example, something like an elegant shirt, right? Black elegant shirt, it's a rare one, it's worth quite a bit of money. If you get one, you'll see it's worth about 2 mil. Then when you roll that, you actually have a 50-50 chance of getting the black elegant top or getting the female variant.
Within the 250.
That's within the 250. So the Ranger boots, we're loving it.
Of getting either one is obviously 1 in 500, so even rarer.
Yeah, so 1 in 500 there. And that's why I say that the masks individually that you're getting, you said, oh, a cat mask, that's pretty terrible.
Oh, so
that
you
actually
get
rolls a random of a number between 0 and 4, so technically it's like between 1 and 5. And it picks out of the 5 different masks available. It's got another strength amity, that's pretty nice.
So you've got 1 in 250 chance, roughly, of landing on a mask, and then it picks a random mask.
Yeah.
Making each individual mask, I don't know how many
there
are.
And when I say 1 in 250, so that's calculated in a number of ways. So it's not just, obviously, you get a chance to get each item per item you roll. It's got another Ranger boots. I swear they're just pumping.
Someone said, hey, RuneScape, I really need a job. Can you hook me up? Thanks. You can apply on the website if there are any jobs available on there.
Yeah, there's always our job postings.
No matter where you are in the world, you can pretty much get a job here if you're willing to relocate. So.
Yeah, no, the sort of HR team here are always brilliant at trying to get people visas when they need them. We've got several people that have relocated across Europe and even like places like Canada and further afield, so it's always opportunities here if it's something you're passionate about. That's the one thing that Jagex really look for, is people that are passionate to work at the company. So definitely get an application in if that's something you want to do. So how are you getting on? Have you seen anything nice? I've seen that.
Someone said, hello James, can we get a skill node please? Now, okay, I'm going to try and give you a skill node. Give me a second. So the way you can put down a skill node is you have to have something called the JMod toolbox open. However, the JMod toolbox does not work in this interface, and this is the interface I like. So, I am going to quickly change off this interface.
I'm doing pretty good on items, I'm not going to lie.
And then I'm going to hope I've got the JMod toolbox, and I don't. So, can you go back to you? I'm going to log out and log back in and hope, I'm pretty sure that's the one way you can get it back.
Go back to me, I'm just about finishing off an invent. We're getting pretty close to 1,000 now, and now you can see an update on my bank. You see that I want 8 Ranger boots and 5 wizard boots, 10 strength METs there, looking really nice. 2 of these black elegant shirts, as I said, they are worth decent money. I've got a second briefcase and I've also got a third offhand briefcase. So really, really racking them up now, which is pretty nice to see. Just like the male and female elegant things that I talked about, that's also how briefcases work. So you can get a main hand and an off hand.
So the mod interface is not working. It's not that it doesn't work. It's there you go. It's a it's just a little tool, and
you
can
close it, and
you can close it. And I don't know. I never made it. It's very new, and I when I'm at work, I'm never in game. So I'm not sure how it works. All right, I've got it now though. So I'm going to put down a.
All right, I'll jump back to you.
Not yet. Let me put it down first.
All right, we'll wait till James gets it down. He's going to dump you guys down a skill node. There. Just so if anyone is coming in-game to hang out, we're in World 5 at the Mosla Harmless Bank. You can come and get a little bit of XP
there
as
you
well.
Go.
So we don't disrupt your
Wail away on the skill node. It's there.
Right, so James dumped down, he's heading back to the bank. All right, okay, back to me. I'm going to progress through because I'm going to hit 1,000, and then after this invent, I'll be on 1,000. I'll do a little bit of a rearrangement of the bank, just so then everything else slots in there nicely, and the remaining 4,000 we've got to go. Adamant Cane coming through, looking like a little bit of a pimp cane. Along with my pith helm, I'll be looking swagtastic. Right, what are we going through? That was a terrible loot. Oh, Guthix's cloak.
Did you say you're almost up to 1,000?
Just over 1,000 now, 1,008. Okay, so, guys, let's have a look at the bank.
You should have 4 ranger boots, in theory.
I've got 8 and I've got 5 wizard boots. Not doing bad, not going to complain. I do have a penguin mask. So let's just start sort of doing a rough organisation here of the bank. Obviously, we'll just go with stuff like cash at the top, and we'll probably just go for all the commodities, so your runes. Like, you really do rack up these runes fast. It may not seem like a lot, but when you consider I've only got 2 Bando's robe tops, and they're not worth that much each.
You have done 1,000 clues.
This is true, this is true. Like, I can't really say that it's a good way to go ahead and get yourself 30,000 mine runes. You're probably better off buying them from a shop. But there you go. We've got some meerkat patches, meerkat scrolls. Obviously, when you actually get those yourself, you do get pretty sad about it because they're not the best loot in the world.
Please add a JMod lodestone. Okay, I can do that as well.
Yeah, we've got us a drop down a JMod lodestone so you can get to. Is that going to be okay? Will it stop people coming here if they don't have the quest? I'm a little bit worried now. I think it should be okay. It should probably tell them you can't get here.
There you go. There's now a lodestone next to the skull.
Oh, we've broken the game. That should be fine. All right. Anyway, let's. I'm being slow here, so let's get this real. God damn it! I wanted to drop runes in it. It swapped them. That's no good. I think that's pretty much my lot. So, Bando's page 3, Bando's page 1. Let's just start dumping all of those in.
Someone has managed to get their dragon through the door. If you look at it, close your bag. Not bad effort. It's got it through the door somehow.
Oh, one of these big flying things. Yeah, right. An Armadale page 2. All right, let's get all the pages together. It'd be nice to get a full page set. I think that'll be one of the hardest ones to actually complete.
Someone asked, what does the JMod lodestone do? Well, the JMod lodestone was something developed alongside the JMod toolbox. And what it means is if I want, I can put down a lodestone in-game, and if you're on World 5, then you can teleport directly to it. So it has a little extra icon on your teleport screen. If you go on your home teleport, there'll be a little extra icon on World 5, and you can teleport to the lodestone. The reason people are teleporting to it now is because there's a skill node down, which lets you kind of chill here if you want to watch and get some extra experience as well.
I can tell because I'm getting a bit of lag.
Yeah, maybe I shouldn't have put it down.
All right. Okay. So no.
Someone's got a purple. I didn't know you could get a purple dragon.
No. Yeah. You can get all different kinds. Oh. They are pretty cool. So I'm not gonna do a full rearrangement, but we'll do maybe in sections. So here you can see I've tried to organise most of the pages together. We're doing pretty well. We need a Bando's page and a Saradomin page, and then one more ancient page, and we've got the set. So I'm gonna go ahead and continue with some clues. James, how are you getting on?
I have just hit 2,130 clues.
Oh my gosh, he's powering through. He is powering through. You're only 20 minutes in.
I've seen so many pith helmets. I don't even want to know how many I've got.
All right, so pith helmet. I'm gonna. I don't actually remember exactly where it is, but they are slightly different. They're a bit more common than your average loot. So pith helmets have a drop rate of around 1 in 250. So you will get that. But also, they appear on another roll. So if you roll to get a certain item, now I'm forgetting which this one is, so I can't, this isn't really, really accurate. But there's another item where if you roll this like 1 in 250 chance, or effectively, obviously this is 1 in 250 over the amount of getting an average of 4 loots from your clue. So it's about 1 in 1,000. If you roll that, you then have a chance to get this item. If you don't get that item though, it gives you a pith helm. So it does have, it does appear twice. So we got another strength MET, looking pretty nice. 10k loots, Addy, 9k loots. This is bad.
Wizard boots.
Bad. Come on.
How many wizard boots versus ranger boots have you got? I imagine you've got more rangers.
Yeah, I had way more rangers.
Okay, so I'm sat at 9 rangers.
Oh, there's an ancient
11
page.
Wizard boots.
I wonder if that ancient page was one of the ones I needed. We got a cloak there. Plenty more roots. Another cloak. 2 semi cloaks. That's pretty good. Another ancient page. Come on, that's got to be ones I need. Completing, like, must be getting, oh, another range boot, 6.9 mil, skip past it there, but Nice to see. So we're now on a total of 9 Ranger boots, 5 Wizard boots. Really powering hard on those. We've got a full boater set. I think, actually, I say that. We've got over 2 full boater sets. So
Oh, he's got sheet masks. That's fairly rare. How many masks? Do you want to compare? Oh, actually, you've got nowhere near as many done as me. So.
Yes. Shall I cut over to you then, and you can show off some of your loot?
Yeah, sure thing.
All right, okay. Going over to James, then we'll see how many he's got.
Right, so I've got, right now, is that 3 sheet? Actually, let's open a few more, and then we'll get to the 2,500, which will be halfway for me, and obviously a quarter away of the total loot. So I click through these fairly slowly.
Yeah, hopefully by that point I could have caught up, and then...
Mitra.
We'll do, when I get to 2.5, once you've done a bit of a reorganisation, by the time you finish reorganising, I'll probably be about 2.5, and then we can do a bank wealth checker, and we'll see how we're getting on. Be interested to see
No, we'll save the wealth check at the end, because I want to
right
know...
Right at the end, okay.
Yeah, I want to know average amount of cash per the
It'd be blue. Interesting to see how that splits over the first half and the second half.
I don't want to ruin it halfway through.
All right.
So how many more have we got to
now
go?
This is another probably 9. The busiest that Mossel Harmless has ever been, let's face it.
Alright, well. Alright,
here we go. A bit worried that I'm lagging even on this computer. We have some pretty nice computers here to bring this to you.
And here we go, this is the final one. So that there is 2,500 clues, all
nice.
In the bank. So 3.3 mil, not bad. I'm gonna put that at the top there. Lots of those. Okay. Loads of teleport scrolls. I've already capped out my biscuits. They cap at 200, by the way.
Oh, okay. Oh, yes. I just got another briefcase that was main hand drop.
So, yeah, biscuits cap at 200, which is annoying. But
I wondered why that was, because I saw that I had about 1,000 purple sweets.
The cool loots. We've got the 9 Ranger boots to 11 Wizard boots, so I guess technically slightly unlucky there, because you would much prefer and get the Rangers.
Oh, that could be where I get you. If I get more Rangers, I mean, it's 7 mil a pop.
Right, I would like to find my briefcases. I'm looking for it. I don't want to use the search function. I want to try and find it, if I've had any.
Black, dude. They're pretty easy to spot. I just got another Wizard boots.
Yeah, I'm on the blue. I'm on the blue interface. Make it
oh, gosh, no.
Oh, yeah, they've got the, yeah, like, hard to see. I've got exactly 5 of the main hand offhand.
Oh,
so
wow.
5 of each on the briefcase.
Another Wizard boots. They
which I guess is quite a lot. Loads of prismatic stars, obviously. I imagine I'm going close to the page sets now. You know, all the different bandos, investment robe tops. Although, so listen to this. 14 Ardor robe tops to 5 bandos, which in theory should be the same. So quite a big disparity there.
Yeah.
The cloaks are fairly close. We'll put these together. Did you properly sort yours out? Like, how properly?
No, I only put the pages together. I was going to do it in batches.
All right, you put the pages together. I think I'm going to put these different vestments and stuff together. So I'll just start throwing these together. I don't know why.
So there we go. You can see some of the loots there.
Oh, actually, I can put these
up here. 2,500 just from the ones that James has been opening.
So I've put the capes up here. I will do my pages later on. I want to put my runes together as well. Just throw these up here. Like so. Wow, 7,000 deaths. Right, I think I got most of my vestments getting
these
around.
Items will be accidentally given to a random player. Unfortunately, JMods cannot trade players.
Okay, but Mod Crisal, he was suggesting to me that we do this thing, right? Well, after we open the clues, we have a script that runs, like a random thing, like an item that we press, and it goes, it picks, like, 3 stacks of things out the bank, yeah?
And
throws them in the party room.
I just don't think that'd be enough. Like, what if you got, like,
I mean, but it could
2,000 Saradomin arrows and, like, some adamant...
Anyway, that's the risk. That's the risk, right? Because it could land on, like, the Ranger Boots stack, which people would be like, oh, we don't want to put those Ranger Boots in the game, but it's we looked it up. It's like, negligible compared to the number that there
anything.
Are.
Oh, I can't actually use the bank because I've got a dragon.
Anyway. All right, I wanted to slowly put these together, but I'm fed up of organising stuff now. Organising stuff. I want to finish opening my clues. I think I got most of my vestment stuff, but there's the loot for the most part from 2,500. So what we'll do is we'll carry on, and we'll see if we get a similar route in the second half, of mine.
All right, so I'm just trying to catch up at the minute. I'm only at 1,750.
Slacking, man.
I can definitely see these pith helms coming through. 19 at the minute. slowly creeping their way up.
I'm looking forward to doing the wealth evaluation at the very end.
He just gets himself another briefcase. Obviously, guys, if you missed last week, obviously there are a couple new items released in the Treasure Trails expansion last year. For easies, you could pick up yourself a suitcase, and you can get a main hand and an offhand variant. They're pretty rare, and they'll set you back a pretty penny as well, about 6 mil a pop. For the mediums, you've got the briefcases. They're very similar in shape, size, but they're black instead of like a ready burgundy, and they'll set you back about 7 mil a pop as well.
So. I just read a comment.
What was that?
Yeah.
Is that about you organising a bank?
No. It's a strange one. It's one of the more strange comments I've seen in a while. Someone says, what does the panic button do? I forgot how the J1 interface opens. I don't want to click it because it's just going to teleport me away. The panic button is... So this little interface here, I can click it. It's got a little crown. This is what allows me to put the skill node over there. And the... where can I get a right click on it? The lodestone there. And all it is a small interface that is only available to JMods, and it's so we can do things like put down the interface over there, etc. We can also do things like transmog, it's called transmog, character into random things. I'll show you at the end of the stream some of the cool things on there.
Mate, the ranger boots are drying up.
But for example, if I go status, I can transmog myself into a Raxi, for example. Now it won't work in here because the area is not big enough and it might break something. So I'm not going to do that. But at the end of the stream, I'll go to an open area and I'll show you guys the stuff. The panic button, which is what the question was something requested. And all it is a button that a JMod can press. And it just teleports me to a safe location. It removes all poison and heals me back to full. So if I'm ever like fighting something on my JMod, I don't know why I'd ever want to use the panic button, to be honest, because I could just set myself to be invincible. But yeah.
Well, it's obviously like we have people in the building that have been like playing RuneScape and obviously doing the tools and the variables and commands for years, and some that are obviously much newer. So it's useful to have for people that don't quite remember how to set their HP to 32,000 or whatever else. So you're just going through a nice style. I saw you got a black Ellie top just then.
People said transmog, is this WoW now? I don't know, as I never played it, but there it just says select a transmog. And all I know is if you, no matter which, either game, if you're in either game, then and you have the rotten potato, there is a button on it called transmogify me, which is what turns you into random stuff. And then obviously like you can set it to be anything you want.
It's just all for a bit of fun. Obviously it's... always a bit of a shock for anyone when they're at the bank at the GE.
I should do what Ronan does, transmog myself into something like a seismic something and put it on the floor.
Just a seismic wand and drop it at the GE.
The thing is, you don't get that on the floor. You get it from obviously looting the... So that wouldn't work. I'm trying to think of something really good that would work. Like, I don't know, go and troll people, killing corp, turn yourself into a divine sigil.
I don't know how you get the loot from Viraga. I've never really... I've never done it myself. Obviously, you loot the corpse at Araxi. I'm not quite sure how Viraga works.
It's a similar thing, but it's like an orb of light.
Oh, of course. No, I have seen those. Ooh, a black headband. Must be stacking them up pretty nicely by now.
Oops, didn't finish that last one.
And the Bando's page.
I haven't seen a ranger boots in a little while. How many are you at now?
So I am now at 2,300.
Right, get to 2,500, and then you can see a comparison of your bank versus mine at the 2,500 mark.
Yeah.
So at 2,500, I had 5 of each briefcase. I had pretty much 2 of each mask, and I had 9 ranger boots and 11 wizard boots.
So it's about 20. Now, I know that I was pretty close not so long ago, so I'm looking at it now, and I'm pretty happy with myself. It's looking pretty nice. But you had 5 of each briefcase, which is pretty impressive. So how close am I getting? We're only a few invents away now. So
let's see
I'll
now.
Be swapping
right,
over in just a second.
All right, 2,400, not far off.
Yeah, not far off at all. Obviously, as James said, what happens is when he's doing them, he's going through nice and slow. So you guys can see some of those loots pop up, but we can spam them a little bit faster and get them open. It's not easy to get 10,000 open in such a short amount of time. So I'm going to change it over to myself in just a second. I'll just finish off this invent. And then I'll be popping over and seeing myself, and we'll be wrapping up with 2,500, which is nice. So, guys, welcome back to my screen, and I'll finish off those last 8. Nothing great. Ooh, 200k Gothic's Cloak, not bad. Had quite a few of those. And I haven't had many Saradomin ones, so we'll see why that's not the case. And there we go, halfway. And we got a U and a Magic combo. Nice. Classic. Right, so I'll deposit those. We can see there's 2,500 left. In tab 2, it's just the Rotten Potato. You have to have that in your bank so that the casket rewards will actually go into your bank. That's something that was put in there just so it's not done on
people spamming giveaway the items. I'm afraid we can't.
So obviously you do get sets of Addy. Ooh, that's not the right Addy. Plenty of sets. Why is that one there? Okay, here we go. So we've got the shields. Now there's magic comps. There's U comps. I've got a few more U comps. But it doesn't look like you get Willow comps. It's really weird. I'm already capped at 200 biscuits. Where's my purple sweet stack? 1,248. We'll put the ingredients here at the top. And then we'll start just trying to pair things out so we can get some of the robes together. 8 Gothic's cloaks, 7 Saradomin cloaks. But look at that, the Zamorak cloaks coming out on top. Obviously things like the amulets you can put together. Now, amulets is an interesting one. So the amulet of strength, you actually get to go on a roll for that. And if you're unsuccessful in getting that roll, you'll get an amulet of power. So if you ever get an amulet of power, feel a little bit sad because you you got the chance to roll for a strength MET and you didn't get it. So that's just tough luck. Now we've got the headband set coming in. As you see, there is a bit of a disparity. It doesn't mean that one's more common than the other. It is just luck. Everything here should, in theory, be completely random and even odds. So it looks like I'm getting damn close to this full page set and I think I might have it here. I've got...
And so just quickly, someone called Soulshard in the chat asked, can you get more than one casket as a normal player? And the answer is no. You'd have to do a clue, open the casket to get another clue, and so forth, and keep doing clues that way.
You can't get that. So I'm going to go ahead and start pairing up the mitras with the cloaks. Because it's so laggy, it keeps on just dropping them randomly. I apologise for that. I'll try and be nice and swift on this. Ancient robes, you've got nine tops, 10 bottoms. Been pretty good on the Armadale ones as well. Elegant, coming in slow, that's the white Ellie skirt. We'll try and pair that with the white Elegant blouse. That's one of the interesting ones. Obviously, you get the black Elegant, actually very valuable. But the black Elegant is not mirrored by a black Elegant female version. I think it's actually mirrored by a white Elegant. There isn't a black Elegant female and there isn't a white Elegant male. It's because they're very similar. Obviously, just they're both white and black, but one's more black and once more white. So I've got 2 briefcases and 7 offhands.
Someone said you don't loot off, don't loot from Virag off the orb. That's the escape.
So there you go. So there's go. 2 and 7. Shows so not journey. As good as you. And also the offhands aren't worth as much. 10 rangers, 11 wizard boots. So that's not quite as good either. We'll try and put some of this Addy G sets together. We're doing really nicely on those. But then again, we have to appreciate that. That's 2,500 clues in. That's not easy to do, so it's not a given that you will get that. Now we've got loads of Addy H5. I'm trying to get some of the masks together, just show you some of the really nice, rarer stuff, more expensive stuff. So we've got 3 masks down here that I'm grouping up together, and we'll get back to doing some clues in just a second, guys. I'll get the Bota set together, let's do that. It's not exactly a big heavy hitter in terms of excitement, but we'll combine it with the fifth elf.
Yes! I want to see some PogChamp. PogChamp. I want to see Bota PogChamp
in the chat. So we've
got
the purple Elegant down here.
Botas are so useless. They don't even look good.
And it's pretty even.
How many Botas did you have?
I've got 9 full sets of Botas.
I've got like 11.
The green ones 11. Coming out on top.
Oh, I've got the 23 red Botas. It's coming
not
out
bad.
Way on top.
Yeah, way, way on top there for you. All right, looking for that Saradomin Mitra. Here it is.
There you go. Bota Simon, there you go.
And then the easiest one is to come out and just group these teleport scrolls. And then I'll pretty much be done for the sorting for now, guys. I want to get back into some clue loots, as does everyone. So you can see I've got pretty much everything by right now. So that's pretty good going. The only thing I think I'm lacking is a sheep mask. And I can't actually see a cat mask. So unless I've got it and just not seen it, I'm still missing that. So guys, we've got to get that. But the page sets in. So there we go, 20k. Oh, there we go, there was the cat mask straight away. Let's just get that in. Oh, nice work. There we go, 4 into it, just one more to go.
So there's an Easter eggs behind the bank. It's a beach ball. There's a beach ball behind the bank.
Right. I think I was just going to fill up now, and then I think I'm
what
good
is that
go.
There? Is that a little goat? The little goat. It's a little goat behind the bank.
I always find that, like, when you click through, it feels like your average key is about 25. That's one of the seven. That's really tragic. But then obviously when you get your 7 mil, that's going to drag up your average massively. So, yeah, that's something to take into consideration.
Someone said nice rigged clue. Cat mask, 1 out of 2004, apparently. Wow. 1 in 2004.
Who said that?
It's 1 in 1, so surely it's 1 in 1250.
It should be around 1 in 1250, yeah.
Yeah, so there you go. Chance of any individual mask, 1 in 1250, roughly.
Yeah, it is very... that is a few off, and I'm intentionally misleading you, but it's about that. So you can kind of, if you've gone 250 and you haven't got a range of boots,
do they just need to replace 250 with 256? Is that how far you've gone?
No, it isn't actually. It's not at all. It's very, very strange. And the interesting thing as well, it's very different to Easy Clues. We looked at the drop tables for both. We'll be looking a bit more in depth at the hard ones. Obviously, next week, guys. Obviously, it's going to be very, very interesting. Hard Clues got so many more unique rewards, but also brings out that elusive Third Age. Oh, those 1.1 mil cloaks. I'm surprised they still retain such value, those Zamorak cloaks.
Oh, the Zamorak cloak.
Is it because it's still used a God Wars item? Is that why everyone's keeping it as a... I know that's why
I
it
know,
used
actually.
To be so valuable.
It used to be valuable, along with, like, the stole was never really valuable. But the Dragonhide tops,
yeah,
like the Zamorak DI top and the Saradin DI top were obviously always
they're from
valuable.
Hards, we'll see those next week.
They were fairly valuable. I don't know why. I think a lot of medium loots were rare because very few people do mediums. As I was saying earlier, easy to get, and hards, you get a lot of them. But mediums, you don't really just get mediums.
I think that really could carry me through. Like, when we do this final price check, like, you may have a couple more briefcases here or there, but if I've got like 10 more Zamorak cloaks, I mean, that will add up. All right. But then if you've got cat masks galore, then...
Are they worth money?
3 mil for a cat
mask. 3 mil for a cat mask?
Yep.
Who would have thought?
Who would have thought? Not me. That's for sure. All right. So we're going through these fairly slowly now. 30k. We haven't had a good one in a while. Come on.
Hang on. Aren't there good masks as well? Isn't there like a wolf mask and a penguin mask?
There is, yeah.
So I'd much rather, if I'm going to dress up in a mask, I'd much rather wear the penguin mask than a cat mask.
It's weird though, because the cloak, the Guthix one's still worth 250k, so it must be down to that rarity factor. Now they, I believe,
is this going to put items into the game? Nope. Even though we're on the live game, we are on mod accounts, moderator accounts, and we cannot trade with players. We cannot interact with the actual economy of the game whatsoever. It's more like the stuff you see will stay on these accounts only, and then tomorrow we'll completely wipe the bank.
Yes. Now next week's gonna get interesting. I'm gonna have to check with a couple of people in the building, because obviously doing 10,000, I bloody well hope that we get some Third Age. And if we do, typically that's broadcast to the server. So I just want to check that JMod broadcasts don't go out. Some players that don't know this stream's going on, they'll probably be quite annoyed when they just see, like, Mod Simon has received Third Age Vambreezes. They'll be like, what the hell? And they'll just think I'm hacking the game, trading it across to my personal account. Obviously, it's not possible, but it's what people's minds often jump to. So 160k loot's not bad. 4k. Wow, so
I'm looking in the chat. If you have any other questions about mod accounts and things like that, I'm looking in the chat. So feel free to ask away.
Yeah. Third age for a medium cloak. No, guys, we were talking about next week. So last week we did the easy clues. This week we're doing mediums. 10,000 medium caskets and next 2 weeks. Oh, there we go. Ranger boots. First in a while.
Do you want to talk to me now and I'll open some, because
absolutely.
I'm at 4,500.
How? Like, I don't understand. You must have RSI. Are you desperate to get home?
No, I was determined that we'd, like, I was convinced we could do it in an hour.
I just
do 10,000.
Oh yeah.
So
we need to stop getting off hands. Yeah, we are on you. So
is it easier to get an RSGF as a JMod? No, good question. Caught it first. I'm afraid I have no idea, because what is that every now and again? Did you see that?
That was the, I think they're called pulse cores.
All right, so I have...
What used to be the...
I'm afraid I am already taken, and I have no idea. So you'd have to ask a single JMod, I'm afraid.
I'd love to see your girlfriend play RuneScape.
Right.
Oh, dear.
Yeah, look, someone's... All right, James. I challenge you to spawn a yo-yo and battle me.
Ooh, 6.9 mil. Hold on. Oh, yeah. All right. I was just showing people my ranger boots. I'm pretty happy about them.
Someone, I'm reading that comment by, yeah, Exa. You see, it's not even near the top now in orange.
Oh, dear.
Someone mentioned Modash. Modash is a legend. I'd imagine.
Taken by Simon. Whoa. What are you trying to insinuate? James is taken by his girlfriend, not by me. I think my fiance would be
Simon
worried.
Simon wishes.
There we go. Right. Boots at the same time. Oh, did you get one as well? Were you looking at my screen?
I wasn't. Oh, I'm just looking at the chat. I'm just slowly clicking. I wasn't paying attention to the chat. I want to see how many are you on.
What, boots?
Oh,
I'm 12 apiece at the minute.
Oh, I just got a pair of Wizzy boots.
Oh, no, I just got another Wizzy boots. So 12, then 13. Oh, man, they're really catching up. That sucks.
I like how people in the chat are now naming female ships. Oh, dear, where do we take this?
Yeah,
guys, any... Oh, someone's asking again what the panic button is. This is a Jmod only interface. It's a little interface that you can have on a Jmod account only. A panic button just teleports you to a safe place. That is literally it. It's not very exciting whatsoever. Again, when I finish the clues, I will show you guys the stuff on the... I'll show you guys the stuff on there. So I'll show you guys where the panic button takes you. I will show you the transmog into different things, like you can transmog, as I showed you earlier, into a Raxor and stuff, and I'll show you that. I'll go to an open space and show you.
Okay. Getting really
you just got ranger boots. Yeah, I did see.
Getting really terrible loots. 4,000
and 12 GP. Can we see you clear the bank? If you want to, I'd like to get at least a screenshot first of all the loot and do the price check and everything. But once we finish with the price check, you can watch me clear the bank if you really want to.
We're going
to
try and make potentially a highlights video of this as well. So, it'd
be great. I'd rather completely organize it. Organize the bank.
I see maybe, someone wearing a ring of stone outside.
Maybe next week when we do hard clues, if you want at the start, I'll wipe the bank and then start over.
He's pulling them in now. He's just got 3 ranger boots in quick succession. We're on 14 a piece of the different boots. That's pretty good going.
Who's the hottest Jmod? That's subjective, so. He's going to forget. You can't trade with no one accounts, so it doesn't make any difference. In fact, just before we started the stream, I wiped the bank of 5,000 easy clues. So
yeah, I was going to say, let's face it, if we were going to do 5,000 clue caskets and trade it across to our personal accounts, I know which clue casket I'd pick. I don't know about you. I'd be going straight for them elites. Don't be pawning them off on mediums. For some reason, my reward interface keeps on closing.
People asking questions about... there's a lot of people asking questions about mod reach, so I'll address it. All I can say is what I've said before, that's that I don't know, and the reason is because I don't know.
Yeah.
maybe people at the very top of the business know, I imagine they do, I don't know, so I'm afraid I can't tell you because I don't know.
You'll find that...
All I can tell you is I don't know.
In any business, matters like that usually aren't openly discussed, so...
Do 10,000 elites,
you've
2 weeks'
more
time.
Than you would usually expect to. It's important that for that old school community that they are very open and they were about that situation, and we can offer no more information because we don't have it ourselves. Like what you know is what we know, which is obviously...
Someone said use wealth evaluator before the wipe. We'll be doing evaluator on both at the very end. So we'll have 5,000 opened clues each, and we'll use the wealth evaluator and then we'll tell you how much you get per clue on average. Over a fairly large number.
So you're must be getting pretty close to the end of it all. How are you
getting
on?
I'm getting fairly close. 4,713.
Is there anything that
you're missing? How long have we been streaming? 46 minutes.
Is there anything that you're convinced you're missing? Or
I have no idea, man. Maybe a mask. Not 100% sure, though. It's possible.
There's 5 masks. Let me just give a check. I'm still a short of mask. Still waiting on, I believe, the sheep mask. Of all the ones, I swear it looks the worst. Never mind. Come on. Sheep mask, I need you. That's pretty worrying, because I am now 3,500 deep. No sheep mask.
So I said you'd ring a bell for hard clues. I forgot. It does take effect now, doesn't it?
It takes effect on all of them, but we're showing the clue loots without the ring of wealth.
Damn, why didn't we think of that? Should we have used it or not?
Probably should have done. We probably should have given information on how it affects it. But we can look it up for next week, guys. Obviously, just if you want to know anything about clues, we're pretty much code novices, but we're looking through those drop tables. It's really quite interesting to see how they've been done, and we can see all the different drop rates. So, yeah, as we've said, when you do a medium clue, for anyone interested, you will get anywhere between 3 and 5 loots. What it does is it gives you 3 always, and then it gives you effectively a roll, and you will either get a number, it's between 0 and 2, so 0, 1, or 2, which will add to those 3 loots. You can get.
Someone said do it with Ring of Wealth to compare. Now, what we can do is we can do that not on stream, because that may open another 10,000 on stream.
But then the problem is it's subjective as well. It doesn't mean you'd get the same. We could you could get.
But over 10,000.
It's a good sample size.
It's a fairly good sample size, 10,000. Someone said, when are the hards and elites? Well, next week, exactly the same time, 9 p.m. or 8 p.m. Is it 8 p.m. game time?
It's 8 p.m. game time, 9 p.m. for us, which is British summer time. But
on a Tuesday, we'll do hards next week and elites the week after. So we're just going through all 4 different types. We just thought we'd do it. It'd be quite interesting to do.
Absolutely.
James asked, skill node expired. James will be to the rescue.
James is going to sort you out with the skill
node. I don't know why it expires. There's something broken about this skill node, because you always click, I want it to be there for 80. I put 80 minutes and it didn't do it. Tools, skill node, there. Based on the fact that it didn't work, I will put it for another 60 minutes.
Guys, I wouldn't encourage you just to come for the skill node. It's not something there that's there to be the best XP in the game at that time. It's designed just to give you a little bit of XP if you were.
Dude, 183
off,
left.
Off
you better be going fast. You need to hurry up, man. 183. I'll take them fairly leisurely, but only 183 left.
And then I get to. You were spamming through way too much.
And that's because you were spent ages organizing, that's why. Right. Someone said, why don't you just adjust the in-game clock? It's annoying in the minute with the summertime. Well, I guess the idea is the clock never changes. It doesn't go through.
Obviously, a lot of British people are saying it's annoying now that it doesn't show the right time. That's because you were used to it showing the right time. you got to remember people like in America.
The daylight savings
are
different.
A large proportion of the RuneScape player base is in America. And so for them, it's been wrong the entire time. It's never even been close, but it is game time. And it's an important time, because it means we can tell you guys exactly when things reset for each day. And that is at midnight every day on the game time, which is obviously really useful. Counts down to things that reset weekly, as well as also shows you events. I mean, if you hover over it right now, it even talks about this very live stream that you can go and watch there.
So someone said, what does a skill node do? It is a node in which, I guess that's what a node is. It is a lump of rock. It's over there. Can't quite see it. It's a lump of rock in which you can do a funny emoter, and it gives you a little bit of experience in a skill of your choice. It doesn't give you great experience. It just means if you want to come here and chill and chat to players while we do this, then you can.
And it's not a total XP waste.
Yeah, it's not a complete XP waste, and the XP is very small. So, it's nothing amazing. But it's something better than nothing while you just hang out, if you'd like to hang out in the background of the live stream. Or just over there. I've put it over there because I don't want it to lag too bad. So it's not actually in the background of the live.
How close are you closing in to your 5,000 then?
So 4,880 right now. How about yourself?
4,880, that's really good. I am on 4,168. So you're going to be, if you go ahead and don't worry about finishing off, and then you can start organising, and I will catch up.
Can you confirm the third age rate from caskets is in the 6 digits? I mean, I guess he means like the 100,000.
I have looked at it and I have been working it out
next week. We'll tell you next week. So next week's hard clues.
I'm going to give you a bit of a cliffhanger, guys. You're going to have to stay tuned and wait to hear all on that one. I have been looking at it. I do know the drop rate for third age. It pains me. It's high. Don't expect to get it.
But yes, we will tell you roughly. We won't tell the exact number, we'll tell you roughly.
There we go, got another strength army tea.
Where's Mo today? he's not on this game, but I'm not even sure myself.
There we go, another Zami cloak coming in nicely, make 21 of those. Guthix ones have caught up though, and they do suck, so that kind of is a little bit lame.
What does Ring of Wealth do for clues now? So in its latest buff, it's had so many buffs over the years. In its latest one, it doesn't give you sigils. Oh, burn. Did you not acknowledge that?
Doesn't give you sigils?
Yeah.
I didn't really acknowledge it.
Do you remember when the Ring of Valve changed and it gave you sigils every kill?
Okay,
it doesn't give you sigils.
I get
but
the burn.
What it does do is it just buffs the loot slightly. By how much? I'm afraid I have no idea. That's something we'll have a look at next week, and we'll tell you roughly what it does for hard clues. Because there's a good chance, you know, I bet it's one of these things where it's like, the Ring of Wrath, it gives you a really good buff, and it gives you no better chance of the good loot. It's just like, see these 33 element darts? That could have been like 66 instead. It will probably be something like that, but we'll have a look at it for next week, and we'll see.
Okay, so I'm pulling up on 4,500 now, pretty much. It's pretty nice. On the closing straights, we'll be seeing between us, obviously, 10,000 clue rewards. Another pith helm.
How many am I coming up? I'm getting close, man. How close are you getting?
As I said, I'm about 500 off, but I will catch up, because obviously you've got to organise, I've got to organise, and we can obviously show through the banks both. So don't worry about homing in on that final figure. I will get there.
I'm getting really close now. Just like one invent left after this one.
One invent, nice.
After this one, so I got two invents essentially. I'm still trying to look at the chat, and predominantly look at the chat to see if any questions going through. Can you put this on YouTube? We'll put a highlight of easy and medium loots on the YouTube channel, so you can see that. We'll do that tomorrow probably.
I'm pretty sure. All right, I think the music stopped. I'm pretty sure I had an hour. I don't know why it stopped.
I'll just go through it again.
Yeah, so. I did. I looped around. I don't know how long it's been stopped for.
Does Vizwax work on the new aura? I imagine by that you mean the aura available from the road trip. And I'm really sorry to tell you, but I don't know.
If it's a temporary one, I imagine if the aura only lasts for a temporary amount of time, which I actually don't know, then it probably wouldn't work. If it's a permanent aura that you can have moving forward, if it doesn't work, I imagine you'll be able to get a request in, and they'll probably will make it work.
I was looking at the chat, so I'm not 100% sure, but I have this feeling it's got back-to-back masks.
Back-to-back masks?
I don't know for sure.
Do you know the tragic thing? In testing earlier, I got back-to-back Ranger boots. Why can't I get that look on my...
There's my total. Account? So there it is. There's my 2,000... Sorry, there's my 5,000 clues.
Wow. He didn't even hype up his last cast.
I have... Yeah. Damn it. Are you going to hype yours then? So I have just finished 5,000 clues. Simon is at... 4,748. So he's getting really close. So while he finishes his off, I'm just gonna kind of group together some of my different things as quickly as I can, because he's gonna be done fairly shortly. I'll try and loot it together. The pages, dude. I don't want to do the pages. It takes ages. All right, there's
only
page
order,
one. There's
only
page
swanky.
Four. Page three. Then we'll go into Guthix.
Ooh, Black Ellie's shirt, 2 mil. I'm interested to see. Page. Go on, give me your briefcase count. That's where you're going to kill me, Ellie.
And I'll tell you when you finish, man.
All right, okay.
All right, then we'll go to Sarah Doman. We've got the page 2 there. Page 3.
Oh, I can see your 4 sheet masks in your bank. That's no fair. But that's the only thing I've got one. I don't even know if that counts as a... I can't even, like, claim victory if I haven't
page
got
1.
Every single item.
Alright, I'm missing a Zami page right there. So then I'll start with Armadillo.
Missing a page?
I don't know, it might be somewhere in the bank. I think it might be the top, actually.
He gets his Strength MET along with his...
there he is, it's all the way down here.
Big gold amulet and his pimp cane, not bad. There is a guy that is continuously doing the gnome copter remote. I don't know whether he thinks he's causing me problems or...
Probably.
He's been doing it for about 45 minutes.
Right, I'm a little page.
I'd love to know what he does as a day job. All right, I'm actually on my last invent, so I'm going to jump across to me.
Yeah, jump across to you, build up some.
There we go, so last invent, 26 to go. All right, can we get something good? 63k, 15k. Ooh, strength MET, 237, not bad. Anything over 100k is a pretty good medium clue. As much as it may not seem like it, it really is. Like, obviously, you can need 18, 9. 192, another strength MET. Wow, already coming out. Got a robe bottom there, but really not worth a lot in terms of GE value, that's for sure. Another page. Oh, Wizzy Boots, 500k, not bad. I should slow these down now. Only 8 to go within the final 10. Wow,
I don't think
terrible.
I completed a page set. Oh, no, there they are. Okay, never mind.
Right.
I'm trolling.
Terrible, 100k. Come on. We've only got 3 left. That's not bad, to be fair. I get a Kite Shield H5 and Ali Four Hound T, obviously worth a bit of money because they are free to play available. not to get, but to buy. 17k, penultimate one, only 23. Last one, here it goes. Oh, only 95k with some Dragonhide G chaps and a Kite Shield. That's pretty weak. But opening the bank, we'll go in and see. Okay, I have pulled out big numbers here. 24 Ranger boots.
17. Oh, man, right, that's a big difference.
Four across. Oh, only 17.
17 Ranger boots.
Okay.
Hang on, I'm going to change my bank interface. Actually, I'm going to leave the interface like this because I've got the gym on toolbox.
So and I've got 19 was a big
21. 21 on myself.
Seven briefcases.
So briefcases, 12.
Ooh,
and I've 10 offhand.
I've got 13 offhand. Oh, but that's two extra. That is 14 mil.
What about the coins? I've got 7.6 mil coins.
7,570. So pretty much exactly
149K
the same.
149K water runes. Ooh, look at
exactly
that.
Exactly the same, yeah.
Okay, how many adamant longswords?
Hold on, I still need to do a bit of organisation here.
No, we don't need organisation.
Please, I'm going to scroll down. Yes! It's there, he didn't see it, but it comes in. The sheep mask.
I don't know why you wanted a sheep mask.
So I could complete the mask set. Dude, I had 8 bat masks and I didn't have a sheep mask. Okay. Right, I need to do some organization. We have the
Addy G set.
We're gonna try and find the Addy T set. Let's get that going in. Right, here we go. We've got the Addy T plate legs. We're looking for the Adam Plate skirt, that looks good. We need the shield. Sorry, we've got 21 Addy T helms. So guys, in terms of like what kind of rate should we expect, I'd say 20 is about right.
Can you help me find the masks? Do I not get them? No, because then it doesn't help you, does it? Because it doesn't go anywhere. Right.
No, you can still withdraw into him.
Oh, I didn't get all the masks.
You didn't get all the masks?
No.
Which one were you missing?
I'm going to figure it out. So nice. I didn't get the masks. So I managed to pick up, what are your masks? I got 4 sheep masks.
1 sheep mask.
Okay. 5 cat masks.
Oh wow, they're worth bank. I've only got 2.
Okay. 6 wolf masks.
2, they're worth money as well.
And then 1 penguin mask.
I've got 4 penguins so what were and 8 bats.
I have no bat masks. And I've had one of them. I know that. Junk, the bat mask, surely.
No, you'd be surprised. Like, hold on, look, examine. G value, 750k.
Okay, how many pith helmets?
Pith helmets, 53. So this is where you see it coming in, guys. So as I said, everything should be about 1 in 20. We see this average out with the boaters here. 20, 20, 16. Okay, but I've got 26 of these. So overall, I've got exactly 100 boaters. Pretty much on average 20 full sets there. Got some Dragonhide chaps. G will combine them with the things. We see it's all working out pretty accurate.
Okay, right, here we go then. So, okay, in the chat, guys, we have opened between us across both accounts 10,000 medium clues. You can see Charles IRL, certainly right, 53 of those. We've opened 10,000 clues between us.
Oh, I don't think I can deposit.
Now, what I want you to do is I want you to guess.
Lol, I can't deposit these prismatics. I withdrew them.
I want you to guess how much the. Use your prismatics, by the way. If you just take out full invent and use them, because, like, Mod Wolf, so they don't know how it works with the Wealth Evaluator. So, use them all.
Okay. Slayer.
It doesn't matter. Yeah, so guess how much money per. Clue on average for each clue. So how much money per clue?
Yeah, I want to see all your guesses in there.
Yeah,
so 57 mil a clue.
No, because I think people, because kind of halfway through my statement, so I think people were guessing how much money total. How much money per clue? Last week, a lot of people said a roughly kind of like 10k etc. for the easy clues, and they were miles off. It was way higher than they thought. But just because of those big ticket items like the briefcase that eventually you'll look out with. I can see some 73k, 76k, 79k, 40k, 52, 82, 37.
Are we going to tell people what it was last week? Because it was.
I'm pretty sure it was 54 for easy average. Yeah.
So there you go. So if you base it off that, guys, I think it was that.
A lot of the guesses around here are somewhere between the 50 and 80k mark, the majority, with a couple of people coming out with the 120s, 132, but the majority are sat around the 50 to 80 mark. Now, do you want to, how many more are used for your prismatics?
Yeah, just but use I'm just doing a bit of organising.
All right, well, that's enough organising. All right, I have used all my prismatics, so now It's time for the Wealth Evaluator to see how much is in my bank.
We've got 24 canes.
A big chunk of it. I'm hoping, I'm hoping I've got more than you.
How
much have you got? How much have you got?
How much have you got?
I have 599,549k.
Pretty much a couple of pennies under 600 mil.
Ignore what's in my coin pouch. The coins, I can show you.
Just withdraw it and drop it. I've got zero in my
The coins are in the bank, so you can see that there. Yeah.
All right, so here we go.
Ignore that.
Come across to Simon. He's going to go for his Wealth Evaluator. Yes!
What'd you pull out?
Oh, yeah! And he does it. 629 mil.
All right,
not bad. 29,629,865.
Give me your exact number. Sorry,
629.
Yeah,
865,001.
Oh mate, you beat you are quite a good
like
chunk.
30.
It was pretty much all
mil.
In those Ranger boots, to be honest.
Rip.
So
James.
Total of 1.2 mil. So
mate, it's those pith helms coming in.
What is
big.
That? Is that 122k a clue?
So over
kind of a lot of you are thinking, but on average,
briefcases and
100 and pretty much 122,941 exactly.
That's
coins.
Pretty awesome, isn't it? Pretty awesome.
See short dude in the chat there. But there you go. That's the average loot that we got from 10,000 clues.
Oh, pretty happy with that. Pretty happy with that. You can't exactly be disappointed. Winning. It's not really a competition directly, but I feel like it is. I feel like I won.
Actually, let's do a vote, guys. Who won today?
Well, it's pretty obviously me.
Did James win or did Simon win? You can put mod James or mod Simon. I've got a feeling I've come in with a generic. People are feeling like I've won today.
I don't know why. There's nothing to indicate that you would have done. You've basically failed all around. I'm trying to do some last minute organising. I don't really know why. Just to make it nice and pretty for you guys.
There we go.
I
see more James.
Simon is a noob. I don't like this.
I see more Jameses in there. I'm going to take that as a win. So I'm going happy.
All right, there we go.
There we go. That's 10,000 medium clues for you guys.
Yep.
Total loot. Do you want to see my bank once again quickly before we end? Because we've seen yours for a while now. Jump over.
Yep.
So this was Simon's 5,000. This is my 5,000. Oh, I was going to quickly show you some of the tools on the Jmod toolbox. So we'll do that quickly. Just highlight the masks there. That I got, this is 5,000 obviously in my bank, 5,000 in Simon's bank, so these are the loot from 5,000 here. And I am going to teleport somewhere, so I'll show you how you teleport as a Jmod, the easy way. And where should we go? Where's a nice big open space? We'll just go to the desert because it just really is open. Alright, we're going to go there. So if I jump over here,
I've got bare fireworks. What about you?
I go on to status. So some cool things I can do in here, like I can put down fireworks. I think it is that. There we go. I've just started a fireworks display. That's kind of uneventful, to be honest. So the thing I wanted to show you was the transmog. So I can just become a Raxi and kind of move around like, there we go. Which is quite big, which is why I didn't want to do it in that small area. Or a Raxi or magic. There you go. But that's what you can do.
Yeah, that's pretty much the
Someone said Wordy. And go for the party hat transmog. What else have we got on here? I've never actually looked through what we have on here. Apparently we have Rory the reindeer.
Nice.
Never
nice.
Seen that guy before.
You can get him as a legendary pet, I believe.
You can go for Nex. It's the new look of Nex, though. Standard zombie. What else have we got on here? We have a burning Christmas tree, in case you wanted to be a burning Christmas tree.
Obviously.
Who doesn't? Okay, Arceli. And I think, Doug, to be honest, you can add anything on here. So you can add anything. But they're the things that are on there at the minute. Obviously, I can turn myself invisible, but that's just some of the tools. Celebrate. Can I celebrate like this?
Pretty sad if you couldn't.
There you go. Look, there's some people appearing. And what else have we got? What should it be?
I'm trying to figure out how I can...
Hang on, is this guy attacking me? Sorry, no, it's my health in the desert. I just saw my health bar. I was like, is this guy attacking me? Like, people saying Virago. Was Virago on there?
Nice panic.
Oh, I've got the panic button, dude. Virago. There, oh, Virago is on there. There you go. There's Virago for you.
You've got to zoom out a little bit.
Virago,
he's pretty beefy. He is pretty beefy. Right, well, there you go. 10,000
These people are just going to be like, oh my god! I guess, like, imagine if I just found a randomer who's not watching the stream. He's like, what the hell?
Yeah, he would be a little bit scared, wouldn't he?
And then I can dance with this person. Something. I wonder if you can dance as Virago. Let's see if it works.
Sure you can.
Yep. He just kind of, like, kind of moonwalk a little bit.
Right.
There you go. There you go. There. That's Virago for you, so you can do that as well. And then I will, what I'm going to do is, I am going to become a crawling hand. And I am going to press the panic button so you can see where it goes. And it teleports me back just to here, which is somewhere you can't actually get to. But if I drop down a level and drop down some more levels, you can see I am now in the Dark Wizard's Tower.
There you go. So, we'll come back to my screen. You can see the aftermath of 10,000.
Oh, that's
please.
Fairly nicely organised. You did that pretty quick, actually.
Yeah, so I had to dump a sheep at the top to cascade stuff down. But we got the full mass set, only one. But if you average it out, obviously, we're looking at, what, 8, 12.
Why'd you put the sheep mask at the top? 70. Is that how much it means to you?
No, just to cascade them down so they look pretty. So we've got pretty much there, yeah, just over 20 added T sets, pretty much the same. 30 shields, not bad at all. We've got all the plate bodies. I'm pretty sure we've got every medium clue item, which is pretty cool. 24 rangers, 19 wizard boots. They are the same drop rate individually. You have no greater or worse chance. It's nothing like the briefcases where you get briefcase and offhand briefcase, and it's a 50-50 between them. They do have their own individual role, hence where you can see it's pretty much double the amount of them. So you'll see very similar amounts of things like Black Elegant, just to show how rare this stuff is, even though it's been in the game for a long time. When you consider it's on the same rarity as the new stuff like briefcase.
Yeah, to be fair, it's also obviously a lot less than those than you've got Ranger Boots. So.
Yeah.
And you also, you beat the drop rate because you're supposed to get 20 over your 5,000.
Yeah, not bad. 20 briefcases in total, but like you can see how rare these masks are. So if you get yourself a mask, as much as it may not always be the most valuable thing in the GE, you can feel like you've got pretty lucky. The Strength Amity is a little bit more common than that. As I said, you do offset that when you go on the same roll. If you get an Amulet of Power, it means you've had the chance to get a Strength MED and you got a little bit unlucky. But not that unlucky, as you see. It's quite an interesting rate. These obviously aren't exact. It's only 5,000. It's a pretty good sample size, but not conclusive by any means. And we've got them BOTA sets, which are awesome. So, guys...
Did you just say BOTA sets are awesome?
They are. Were they awesome or pretty awesome? I don't know.
All right, anyway, there you go, guys. That's 10,000 medium clue scrolls. I guess thank you for watching.
Absolutely. And next week, guys, 10,000 hard clue scrolls. How many pieces of Third Age are we going to bring
10,000 hards
into the game? Obviously, when I say into the game, it's into a game and then delete. Don't panic.
Yeah, they're not coming into the game. Don't worry. All this stuff gets deleted. So, yeah.
We will need to check that it doesn't go on a broadcast. I'm pretty concerned about that. Well, I'm sure there'll be a check in there. The people in this building are extremely smart, so I'm not worried. They'll figure it out for sure. It's going to be a lot of fun. And then, of course, 2 weeks' time, guys, you're going to have the elites as well. Obviously, with the easy and medium, only one extra reward really added into each. But it's nice to see some of these briefcases coming in. And then you'll get to see a lot of new things. Your backstab capes, hopefully they're extremely rare. As well as things like your sack of effigies and your explosive barrels. But yeah, the Third Age is always that elusive, brilliant item. So guys, thanks very much for watching. We will catch you again sometime soon.